at New Avron's home studio in West Hollywood, California. Once we got all of those basic tracks, like the foundations laid, I went in and spent a handful of days doing overdubs, doing vocals and background vocals, and we have a guitar player coming, and we're doing some keyboards.
Let's have you sing then.
I think we've got a great start, and now it's putting those little bells and whistles, as needed, onto the record to kind of make it feel like a finished product.
I love being in the vocal booth, though. I don't know, I get goosebumps sometimes just getting the opportunity to be in the studio and singing and having the music wrapped around it. It's one of my greatest joys.
That was good. Listening back.
We had Blake Mills in the studio. Blake is an incredibly inventive guitar inventing, which is a technical term. A lot of people don't get that.
It's cool to come in at this stage and hear what's already been played and try to find a little gap in the fabric.
He's just this really prolific artist.
Sarah and Neil work really well together, both with musicians and building the arrangements.
I have a song called You Matter to Me, and I asked my dear friend Elizabeth Zeman, I asked her to do a string arrangement for me. So she wrote this incredibly beautiful sort of chamber piece. We had a day at Electric Lady that was just so fun. It was so beautiful. Nothing like live strings. So much better than dead strings. I mean, right? We did a day of keyboard overdubs at Zach Ray's studio in North Hollywood, where every keyboard in the world seems to exist. He has great instincts as to how to kind of fill out a sound.
Kind of just continuing the thought of that sound.
And he's got a great goatee, which you really can't go wrong. It's so important when you have musicians coming into the studio that you have people that are sort of like a fountainhead of ideas.
Yeah, let me try that.
It's cool too.
When they kind of are down to go on the exploration with you.